हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज डाउट सेशन फॉर द टेस्ट दैट वॉज कंडक्टेड ऑन 30th मे एंड हियर आई हैव टेकन फोर डाउट्स, द फर्स्ट, 11th, 13th एंड 14th. ओके, सो मेक श्योर दैट यू आर ओके विद द सोल्यूशन, इफ नॉट यू आस्क मी. ओके, सो वॉट द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन दे आर आस्किंग इज, देर आर 100 कोप्लेनर फोर्सेस ईच equal to 10 newton act on a body. Each force makes an angle pi by 50 with the preceding force. Preceding means the previous force. What is the resultant of these forces? So this is a very simple question and tricky question unless you know the concept. So we will go with very basic question, basic concepts. Like, let's say there are two forces acting on a body. Let's say this is force 1, let's say 10 newton, and here another force 10 newton. Only two forces are acting, let's say. So if I try to find out the resultant of these forces, I will first take this 10 newton like this, and then, or here for a minute you can check the angle they are making with each other is 180 degree. Here also it is 180 degree. So there are two forces and the angle they are making with each other is 180 degree. So next, let's say this is force 1, this is force 2, this is force 1, and the force 2 has to be kept, the tail of the force 2 has to be kept on the head of the force 1. So it will come like this, and here you can see the resultant is coming out to be 0. Okay, so this is the first concept. Let's say for making it more clear, let's say there are three forces. There are three forces, like this is force 1, or I'm taking it as F only, the equal magnitude. Second is like this, say, and third is like this. So each force, for example, is making an angle 120 degree with each other. Okay. In this case, if you try to find out the resultant, we will take this force 1 first. Then let's say F1, F2 and F3, but all of the forces are having equal magnitudes. So F2 will be like this. Okay, this is F1 and F3 will be like this. It will be a closed figure. It will be a closed figure. Here you can see this angle is 120 degree. So this is 60 degree. So here what we can say, there are three forces. Okay, there are three forces. And they are making angle 120 degree, and that's why the resultant is coming out to be 0 here also. Okay, so just look at the red colored boxes here. Two forces at 180, three forces at 120. Or if I take one more question like this. So there is one more question, like on a body there are four forces are acting like this. F2, then this is F3. And this is F4. Okay, so in this, if I want to find out the resultant, I will take this F1 first, then let's say F4, then let's say F3, because we know we can take in any order we want. So I'm taking the easiest order, and this is F2. So this is F2, this is F3, this is F4, and this is F1, and we know that their magnitudes are equal. So that's why the figure is coming out to be a closed figure, and the resultant obviously it will be a 0. So here you can see there are four forces and they are making an angle 90 degree with each other. So there are four forces, they are making an angle 90 degree with each other. So if you go further, taking five forces, taking six forces, taking seven, or even if you take 100 forces, the pattern will be same. So here we can say, if there are number of forces, let's say n number of forces, okay, and let's say theta is the angle between the forces. Here, to be precise, we will take these are vectors, okay, not forces only, any vector you can take, and theta is the angle between the vectors. Okay, so if the forces are of equal magnitude, the first condition is that forces are of equal magnitude, all the forces, and if theta into n is coming out to be 360 degree. The resultant will be 0. This is a basic concept you can say. Like in the first example, if you see, there were two forces. Okay, so number of forces were 2 in the first concept. There were number of forces were 2 into the angle between them was 180. It is coming out to be 360. That's why the resultant was 0. In the second example, there were 3 forces and they were making angle 120. The answer was 360 degree. So resultant is 0. Okay, so in the third example also, if you take the 4 forces, the angle between them is 90 degree. It is coming out to be 360 degree. So obviously the resultant will be equal to 0. So I think you are clear up to here. The concept behind this, I think you are clear. So in this question, what they are saying, there are 100 coplanar forces, each equal to 10 Newton. Means the magnitudes are equal. So we can go with this concept. If the magnitudes are equal, we can go with this concept and we can check out whether the resultant is coming out to be 0 or not. So what they are saying, the number of forces are 100 and the angle between them is, I think, pi by 50. So if you multiply n with theta, it will come out to be 100 into pi by 50. So 51 is a 50, 52 is a 100. So this is coming out to be 2 pi, and we know that 2 pi is nothing but 360 degrees. So here also, in this example, the resultant is coming out to be 0. I think this example is clear to you. If not, you ask me at the doubt. Taking the second example, express the given angle in radians. Oh, sorry, in degrees they are saying. So we know that if you want to convert any radian into degrees, you need to multiply it by 180 by pi. Okay, and the reverse is also true. If you want to convert any degree into radians, you just multiply it with pi by 180. I have told this, isn't it? So we will go with the first concept here. It is 2 pi by 15. If you multiply by 180 by pi, so here the pi value gets cancelled out. 15 ones are 15, 15 ones are 15, 15 twos are 30. So this will be, I think, 24 degrees. So this is the answer of this question. Just check it out. You should include these kind of concepts in your short notes, because they are pretty important for your examinations. Okay, so let's go to the next question. 13th question. What they are saying, that if 3 tan theta is equal to 3 tan alpha is equal to 4, then find out the value of cosec alpha minus cot alpha. So I have told you, in such kind of questions, the first priority will be making the triangle like this. So in that, let's say this is alpha, and here they are saying that 3 tan alpha is equal to 4. So tan alpha can be written as 4 by 3. So this will be 4, this will be 3, and obviously this will be 5. And then they have asked us to find out cosec alpha minus cot alpha, or you can write it as 1 upon sin alpha minus 1 upon tan alpha. And if you substitute these values, 1 upon sin alpha for this angle alpha will be 4 by 5, and tan alpha for this angle will be 4 by 3. So this value will be 5 by 4 minus 3 by 4, and this will be 5 minus 3 is 2, 2 by 4, that is 0.5 or 1 by 2. So it is easy question. Okay, most of the students maybe they have solved it in this way only. Remember these steps. Okay, now coming to the last question, it is also very imaginative. Consider a cube ABCD PQRS. So this is ABCD and this is PQRS. Okay, so this is a cube. If theta is the angle between diagonal BS, so here this is the diagonal they are talking about, BS, and the plane PQRS, and the PQRS plane is like this. So with this plane, they are making an angle theta. If you imagine this, here your imagination should be very great. then only you can imagine this. And this is a concept like this is a problem called chocolate problem, if you see. Okay, so they are asking about find the value of tan theta. If you can imagine this cube, you can easily find out tan theta, because if you see here, this tan theta, this is the triangle we are looking for. Okay, so this is the triangle. If I look it from this side, this will become like this, and this is the theta, and this is the QB side we are talking about, and this is the third vertex S. So if you want to find out theta, let's say this side is Y and this side is X. So they are talking about it is a cube. Okay, so every edge, every side will be same. Let's say this side is, let's say A. So obviously the BQ side will be also A. But if you see the QS side will not be A. So if you look from the top, what is we are getting? Here it is P, here it is Q, here it is R, here it is S, and we want to find out this. Here we want to find out this length. So if this is A, this is A, this is root 2A. This is a Pythagoras theorem. I have told this. So this is root 2A. And if you want to find out the tan theta will be what? A upon root 2A. This AA will get cancelled out, and the answer will be 1 upon root 2. That is the C option. Okay. I think everyone is clear with this. Check. If not, you ask me the doubt. Okay.